stands at the crossroads of history as her millions of qualified voters stream to the polls to determine whether she shall remain a free republic or sink silently behind the Iron Curtain in the gray zone where slave nations are governed by Moscow's will. The election, which lasts almost two full days, is held under the watchful eyes of 300,000 troops and police. It is the culmination of a bitter battle in which both Western powers and Russia exert strong pressure. Trieste, often a political pawn, again finds itself an issue in the East-West struggle. The United States has advocated its return to Italy. Russia has flatly rejected the proposal. Citizens hear arguments from both sides. 574 deputies and control of the Senate are the stakes in this desperately fought election. Leading freedom-loving Italians is Prime Minister De Gasperi, head of the Christian Democratic Party, who has the solid backing of the church, whose home is menaced by communist aggression. His followers are supported by millions of letters from Italian Americans and hundreds of shiploads of American food. Palmiro Togliatti, Moscow-trained and considered one of Europe's outstanding Reds, leads the communists in their desperate campaign of violence. The elected officials will determine Italy's government, slave or free. But as 29 million Italians face their grave responsibility, returns indicate a sweeping victory for the forces of freedom. An anxious world breathes easier as, with incomplete returns tabulated, Italy meets communism's challenge with a resounding no.